Come in, Lieutenant. This is General Garza. I'm afraid your leave will have to be cut short. A critical situation has just been brought to High Command's attention. Havoc Squad is needed immediately. Report to my office on Coruscant right away. We'll discuss things further when you arrive. Garza out.
Great. If High Command is worked up, this can't be good.
Let's move out, people.
Lieutenant, welcome. Stand at ease. We have a lot to discuss, and not much time to do it in. Please ignore my other visitors. Tavis's testimony at trial has created a great deal of interest in my day-to-day affairs.
Tavis had a right to trial. I never intended it to lead to anything like this, General.
No apology necessary. Let's just get on with our work. First, for demonstrating exceptional discretion in the capture of numerous key enemy personnel, you are being awarded the Bronze Crescent. In addition, due to your exemplary leadership under the most dire of circumstances, you are hereby promoted to the rank of Captain, effective immediately. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, General.
You've more than earned it. I've called the other members of Havoc Squad here so you can designate one of them as your executive officer. Your XO will serve you as second in command and be promoted to the rank of Lieutenant. As droids cannot hold rank, your choice is between Sergeants Jorgen and Dorn.
Let's start with you, Jorgen. Why should I give you this promotion?
Are you serious? I was Lieutenant when you met me. I was an operations officer on Ord Mantell for more than 3 years. If Tavis hadn't left the lazy jerks upstairs hungry for a scapegoat, I'd still be a Lieutenant. Besides, you've seen my results in the field. I'm obviously the most qualified for executive officer.
Sergeant Dorn has done a lot for this squad, Jorgen.
Yes, she's a great medic, and she knows the regs, but she doesn't have the training or the experience that I have, sir. Thank you for hearing me out, sir.
Tell me what makes you the best choice for the job.
I believe my service record speaks for itself, sir. In spite of my short time in the Republic Army, I have received multiple commendations and glowing performance reviews. As you've seen firsthand, I carry out my duties professionally and precisely at all times. Finally, I have extensive personal knowledge of the tactics and training of our enemy. More so, perhaps, than any other soldier in the Republic.
Sergeant Jorgen already has a lot of command experience.
Yes, sir. But I think you'll agree that Sergeant Jorgen's combative demeanor is not a recommended quality for a position of authority. Thank you for allowing me to speak, sir.
Eric Jorgen, you are hereby promoted to the rank of Lieutenant.
Finally back where I started. Thanks, Captain.
Now, let's discuss the reasons you were called here. An SIS agent working undercover in the Imperial military has made a critical discovery. The Empire is constructing an experimental new superweapon, codename Gauntlet.
How dangerous is this thing, General?
We're short on details, unfortunately. The agent is in too deep to risk transmitting any further information. Our only option is a rapid extraction. That's where Havoc comes in.
We'll pull the agent out immediately, General.
The extraction will take place on Tatooine. An SIS agent will meet you there with the full details of the operation. Failure is not an option, Captain. We have to learn what the Gauntlet is and what it's capable of, no matter the cost. Dismissed.
Captain, good to see you. It was a big relief to hear that Havoc could make it out for this one. Congratulations on the promotion, by the way. How's it feel to be so big and important?
I tell people what I want, and they do it. Just the way I like it.
I knew I should have signed up for the Army. So, you know that you're extracting an undercover agent who has intel on the Empire's new superweapon, codenamed Gauntlet. The agent's name is Prellan Garn. He's done his part. The transport he's riding just made an emergency landing in the desert under mysterious circumstances.
I'll find the landing site and pull our man out ASAP.
Garn's ride was an Imperial troop transport, so expect plenty of security as you approach. Once our agent is secure, be sure the scene is clear and make your way back. Good luck.
Sir! Enemy soldier spotted!
Defend defensive positions. Squad 2, advance on my...
Here, get down here!
Keep your head down! I'll be right there!
Traitor! Shoot him!
Ah, that felt good. You don't know how many times I had to talk myself out of murdering that walking scum.
More imps could be on the way. Let's get you back to safety.
You're right. The rescue team will be here any second now. But we can't leave yet. I need to rig the ship to blow. That should vape all the evidence of my little disappearing act. Can you cover me?
Get to work. I'll keep you safe.
Much obliged.
Timer's set. She's ready to blow.
Go, go, go!
Welcome back to the loving arms of the Republic, Prellin. It's good to see you.
Good to see you too, Jonas. Your friend got me out with all limbs intact. Guess that means I owe you 20 credits, huh?
Ah, Captain. You brighten my day, fatten my bank account, and gun down imps like maimed banthas. Marry me when this war is over.
We'll stick to drinks for now. You know how to find me.
Sounds like a plan.
All right, knock it off, kids. We got business to discuss. The Gauntlet, the Empire's new superweapon. It's a massive cannon built into the frame of an Imperial battlecruiser. But it's no ordinary cannon. The Gauntlet can fire on ships traveling through hyperspace, where they're completely helpless. Warships go down in one shot.
A weapon that powerful could win the war by itself.
Exactly. We have to move fast to stop this thing. I've got a full report ready. Once Jonas gets me to a terminal, I'll send the details to General Garza.
You'd better head back to Coruscant, Captain. Garza will have Prellin's report by the time you get there, and I'm sure she'll want to keep Havoc Squad in the loop.
I'll head for Coruscant immediately.
Take care, Captain.
Ah, Captain, you've arrived. This is Fleet Admiral Newman, head of the Republic Navy's 5th Assault Fleet, and Supreme Commander Rans, overall head of the Republic Armed Forces.
Good day.
We've both heard a great deal about you, Captain.
Given our present circumstances, Fleet Admiral Newman and Supreme Commander Rans have come here to plan a full-scale joint operation to deal with the Gauntlet superweapon.
I'm honored to meet you both.
It's unfortunate that we couldn't meet under better circumstances. As you know, the situation is dire.
A single operational Gauntlet device gives the Empire a decisive military advantage. But Agent Garn's report has revealed the enemy's true plan: mass production.
If the Gauntlet prototype is completed and the Empire succeeds in producing more of them, we're doomed. The entire Republic would be conquered in a matter of weeks.
There must be something we can do to stop this thing, sir.
Destroying the Gauntlet will require a coordinated naval and infantry strike of unprecedented scale. Our forces must begin preparing now.
In the midst of the assault we're planning, a single commando team will board the Gauntlet and sabotage it from within. We've chosen Havoc Squad to carry out this task.
Havoc Squad will be proud to end this threat to the Republic, sir.
Your team will need to be expanded. You'll need a technical specialist and an explosives expert.
The General and I have scoured the entire Republic personnel database to locate the two most highly qualified specialists available.
Both men are engaged in active operations, the first on Balmorra. Extract him and return here as quickly as possible. Understood?
If I have your leave, I'll get started immediately, General.
Absolutely, Captain. The sooner Havoc Squad is at full strength, the sooner we can begin the assault on the Gauntlet. Dismissed.
Captain, I understand you've reached Balmorra. Let's get straight to it, shall we? Imperial forces conquered the planet during the First War, but a Balmorran resistance movement has fought the occupation to this day. Republic support for the resistance has been inconsistent over the years, but now our forces are pushing to drive the Empire off Balmorra for good.
If our people need backup, they can count on Havoc Squad.
Your primary objective, of course, is the recruitment of Havoc Squad's new explosives expert. His name is Tano Vic. Vic is a Weequay, and a natural at demolitions work. but he also has a history of insubordination and collateral damage. Keep him on a short leash.
I'm sure I can keep him out of trouble, General.
I hope so. To be clear, Vic's infractions were not minor, and they led to his dishonorable discharge over a year ago. He is, however, the most skilled demolitionist on record, and Havoc Squad needs the best.
I'm sure he'll work out fine.
Just be sure to keep an eye on him. Vic is currently fighting as a mercenary for the Balmorran Resistance. His supervisor is a Resistance leader named Arden. Meet with Arden. Learn where Vic is stationed and pull him out as quickly as possible. Contact me again when you've done so. Garza out.
So let's focus on those war mechs landing on the plateau. Look, it's one of our dependable friends from the Republic. Meeting's over, people. I wouldn't dream of keeping a Republic officer waiting.
I'm here to speak with Tenno Vic. Do you know where I can find him?
General Garza sent me a message explaining everything. I've got Vic's current assignment details right here. I'm glad to hear the Republic's finest aren't here to help, but to take away one of my best men instead. We're honored, really.
We wouldn't be taking Vic if the situation wasn't serious.
I know. Everything is more important than Balmorra to you people. Vic is taking one of our teams on a patrol run. Their next stop is our signal interception post. You can catch up with him there. Now if that's all, there are real soldiers who need my time.
Thank you for your cooperation.
Oh, anything for the Republic.
Scanning Sector 2. Nothing. Just like the others, Prand.
Excuse me. I'm looking for Tenno Vic.
Ah! Oh! You're with the Republic. I thought I was dead meat.
Looking for Vic, huh? That weak-way scumbag is long gone.
It's imperative that I locate him immediately.
Vic was here earlier, but he slipped away when we weren't looking, along with our entire security team. All he left was this holo recording.
Gentlemen, Tenno Vic, 53rd Irregulars. I'm afraid your fine security team is being co-opted for a very important top-secret mission. This is all on Republic orders, of course. Part of the big push. Take a look at Regulation 235R. You'll see that everything checks out. Have a good one.
The Republic wouldn't tap a mercenary for a top-secret operation.
Yeah, didn't make much sense to us, either. Vic is the least of our problems. With security gone, Imperial commandos have breached the perimeter and started sabotaging our equipment. All of our comm relays are down. General Rakdon himself could march an army through here, and we would have no way to warn anyone.
Is there any way to get the relays back online?
Judging by the way the relays cut out, I'd guess the imps just yanked the power couplings. Easy fix, but the problem will be fighting through those commando teams. Do you think you can manage it?
I'll have the relays back online in no time.
Just like that, huh? Just another day on the job. We'll try to hold down the fort while you're gone. Good luck.